All right. We gotta talk to her. We gotta talk to this biddy.
The family.
But I mean, I want to be like, I'm your lawyer. What about your family?
I only had my sister.
You're not Southern.
It's too easy now to fall into that hole.
You're right.
My father died when I was very young. And I don't know where my mother is.
Don't know. She could still be alive. Right? Your mother. Let's open that wound up. Just stick a knife in there and twist it open.
The women in my family have been mediums for generations.
No, I don't want to talk about your crazy...
They say a lot of spiritual power runs in our blood.
I know. I don't want to talk about your stupid religion. Tell me about your mother.
About 15 years ago, our family was involved in a incident.
Oh.
It was a human sacrifice to appease a guru.
A who?
A guru.
Oh, he sounds...
He's a being of immense power. And we believe that next Tuesday he is coming to save the world.
Next Tuesday, you say? Okay, oh, there was a man.
There was a man, and he... He ruined our mother's life.
Ruined?
He got her pregnant with my sister.
He was my father. He is my father.
After that, she disappeared. Mm. Several years after that, my sister announced she would become a lawyer, and she left the mountain.
So, you live by yourself? No boyfriend? Husband? Boyfriend? Husband?
You're very subtle.
Boyfriend?
I'm being sarcastic.
Girlfriend? Can I watch, I guess is what I'm saying. You know I can't participate, but...
Yes, I've gotten used to it. Oh, also, I had to become independent, or I would lose my powers.
What? I feel bad for her. So dumb. All by herself, up on that mountain. Ooh, your mother's enemy. Okay, yeah, that's a good place to go. So, who was this man who, ruined your mother?
About 15 years ago. There was an unusual murder case. It made quite a stir.
Yes, of course.
Everyone was talking about it, apparently.
Stirring like the pot, I get it.
The police were running out of leads, and they were getting desperate.
Desperado, Antonio Banderas, good.
No.
I get it.
It was an okay movie.
You know, Robert Rodriguez getting his... gun in the guitar case.
Well, that was a fun scene.
The whole movie's pretty alright. Wait, didn't you use a spirit... they didn't use a spirit medium, did they?
The police convinced my mother to try to contact the victim.
Mm-hmm. Wow! So what happened? I'm sure everything turned out roses.
The case was solved, we thought.
You thought?
Yeah, apparently all the information we came up through our spirit medium powers, it was all wrong! Every last bit of it. We thought, you know, she was near water. She was with water.
Water.
They found her in the desert. She just ran away to the desert. We had her whole family convinced she was dead. Drowned to death.
She just went to Burning Man.
She just went to Burning Man. The man my mother helped the police capture was innocent.
for murder. What? How could you ever think this?
The police's consultation with a medium had all been carried out in secret, of course. Because they don't want that shit getting released in the press, I'll tell you. A man found out about it and leaked it to the press. He told all the papers that my mother was a fraud. Mm-hmm. Media jumped at it big time.
The
terrible media jumping on you for being wrong when you're wrong 90% of the time. They just don't understand.
All we did was wrongfully commit a man of murder.
All we did was consult the spirits and tell them the ancient wisdom of the ninth dimension.
Whoa. So your mother was alive.
My mother became the laughing stock of the nation. Nobody took her totally serious powers seriously after that.
I see. Yes.
White.
I think you're Asian.
White.
Is this?
We're white Asian? I don't know. What am I getting at?
Is this about the ghost in the machine casting?
I'm kind of terrified of what this next line's gonna be now. Really.
Excuse me. Are we whitewashing this conversation now?
That was his name.
Oh.
Oh, thank God that's all it is. Oh, woo! My sister told me.
White. Yes.
Just a little longer now before the state-appointed lawyer comes, I guess.
Wow! Listen, I get it that I'm new at this, but come on.
Yep, state-appointed lawyer!
What should I do? Do I just leave her and go home? No! Phoenix.
I wonder if go home is like a game over.
I was just thinking that. Like, I don't want to test it because I really want to defend her.
I don't want to know what we'd have to go back and redo.
Right.
So
I'm going to defend it. I've made up my mind. It has nothing to do with your wishes. I'm going to defend you, whether you want me to or not.
Really? Because my psychic powers told me that you were just going to go home. They were wrong again. Huh?
More so, you can just do that? I'm your lawyer now. No, I don't want
no.
you.
No, really, there's a state-appointed lawyer on the way.
I'm going to tell them that I'm your lawyer.
Oh, no.
Gulp.
Why would you do this to me?
Why? Well...
What would Phoenix say?
Someone else is the culprit.
How do you know? Do you have psychic powers too?
Because I saw the cutscene. I have a hunch.
Oh, good. Because those are usually far more accurate than our predictions in the medium business.
Yep, that's right.
Given the evidence, it would be easy to assume that Maya was the killer, but there's something about this whole thing that smells.
I haven't washed my lady parts in a week. I'm sorry.
Girl. Bitch, and you smell like the penguin. That witness's strange behavior, was that all an act? And the way the lawyer refused to help out Maya. But more than all that, she has no one left to help her.
I know, that was low-hanging fruit, and I am ashamed.
What?
The lady bits.
Yeah!
Yeah, that was low-hanging fruit.
Yeah. It was, but you know, listen.
Look, this is live broadcast, folks. This is live.
This it just comes as it comes, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Nothing is more sad or more lonely than that. I know. I've been there a long, long time ago. Why did I become a lawyer in the first place?
Because someone has to look out for the people. If Phoenix Wright was a musical, what would happen.
Moonfront says,
who have no one on their
pro
side.
Tip. Look, it's no doom song. Unless somebody puts like a kick-ass musical accompaniment. Why don't you just go on for a bit? We'll see what happens. Okay. Pro tip, says Moonfront.
Yeah.
You can press start and save at nearly every point in the game. Oh. It's like the saves in Sierra games. Ooh. They're your friends. You should actually probably right now.
Maya, I will defend you. No, I don't get it. It's not Doom.
Yeah.
You know what? Here's the thing. You got in my head.
Oh no.
You put the Doom song in my head, and then I started to get a little psyched up. You got in my head.
I'm sorry.
You can't just let it flow.
I just
anymore.
Ruined the stream. Completely ruined.
Completely ruined. Maya, I won't abandon you. You can count on me. I'll be your lawyer, girl. I'll even waive the fee. See,
that was a little. Oh, yeah, you gotta do it now.
A little better.
You have to work objection into there.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Well, that's for the court number. Right? Objection, Your Honor! Objection, the court! Objection, the jury! I just realized that it'd be really hard to rhyme something with court. I couldn't think of anything to rhyme anything with court.
Fort.
Right?
Sort.
Objection, the jury! I'm building a fort out of evidence.
If you really want to stretch it, mort, like death. The victim is mort. We'll take it to court.
Port, sport. Court. I went with court. Listen, you got to come up with rhymes in 2 seconds, though. That's the problem. Sport. Oh, sport. I like sport.
Ooh, yeah.
Objection, judge. Objection, the jury. Objection, the court. We won't be playing games with my defense witness. This is no sport. Yeah, come on. No, you know what? Alright, that's fine. Hey, whatever. You know what? Whatever.
Nick Nevinger?
Oh, yes.
Says, FYI, Phoenix Wright, as I recall, is supposed to be set in Southern California, not Japan. It's just Japanese based. Strange, but to my knowledge, true. Also, it's an Avenger.
Oh.
In case you get it wrong.
We,
I think that's what I said, isn't it? I got it right, didn't I?
Sure.
I said Avenger.
You might have said Avenger. I don't know.
Though it's a fine prediction that we would get it wrong.
We usually do. The word you're looking for is what?
Tort is the word you're looking, and then it's kind of cut off.
Tort?
It's a legal term.
Oh, really?
Huh.
That would have been great. I don't know what that means, though. What does tort
mean? Use tort in a sentence.
Right? Tort. Tort does not sound.
Localization is supposed to take place in SoCal,
oh, sure.
But the originals are in Japan. Which causes problems later on when extremely Japanese shit happens.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Okay, tort is non-criminal law. That'd be kind of hard to weave into the... Really, I just need to not have the rhyme be on court. Oh, what?
Anonymous says, just admit that you rigged the wheel of the worst. Here's the thing.
I like the new wheel. I like it.
The old wheel was the... I'm going to use air quotes here because it's necessary.
Use them.
The old wheel was the rigged wheel.
Not really. Explain.
Because the old wheel was designed to look like a piece of shit.
Yeah.
I just used like random pieces of wood when I built it.
Yeah.
But the woods were like different weights. Mm-hmm. And I tried my hardest to balance that wheel.
Right.
There's a whole bunch of shit glued behind the old wheel in a... half-assed attempt to balance it, but it was never really balanced.
Yeah,
the wheel favored one side heavily over the other.
Heavily.
Heavily. And so I recently remade the wheel. Mm-hmm. I tried to get it more balanced.
Yes.
And I also put like foam behind there so it's more taut.
Yeah. Which is great, by the way. Like, so when you give it a good... The thing I love about the new wheel is when you give it a good spin, it stops.
Yes, and it doesn't... The way, if there is an unbalance, the weight's not going to carry it back the other way.
Exactly, which happened with the old wheel.
Which is sometimes what happened with the old
wheel.
So this is actually a far less rigged wheel, and I'm seeing all these comments like, it's brakes, they're rigging the wheel. Like we build some kind of complicated foot pedal to stop it. If we wanted to rig the wheel, we would just spin it until it landed on the tape we wanted.
Honestly, with editing, that would be incredibly easy to do.
Yes! This is what I get for making the wheel more honest.
I'm looking forward to you distressing the wheel to make it look a little more jagged.
It needs to look more.
But I like the new wheel. I like it. And it is random.
Yeah.
It absolutely is.
The new one is much more honestly random.
Yes, agreed. You're sniffing drugs. I'll save after we're done with this conversation. Well. Oh, wait. Let's stand up. My stand-up timer went off right during your wheel discussion.
Everybody, it's time to stand up! Oh, my legs. This is why we stand up. So the easy rhyme is like objection, judge, objection, I say. And then you can rhyme with anything, right? Objection, judge, objection, I say. You will find my client innocent today. Dun 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 dun. The evidence suggests a different story than they're telling. I'm not buying the bullshit they're selling. Phoenix shouldn't swear, though. But that's the song right there. Did what?
Did you just recently, like, rewatch the Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt Daddy's Boy episode or something?
The Daddy's Boy episode?
The 1940s musical, Daddy's Boy. Just musically, it sounds like that's what you got in your brain.
Well, I just watched season two. Or that might be season one, the Daddy's Boy. I don't remember. That's just, like, this generic, like, operatic musical theater, so I'm not going for any song in particular. Boy. The Real Veon says, I think people are saying the wheel was rigged because before you always showed a wide shot of the wheel stopping, but in the new episode it was all close-ups.
Here's what I'm gonna guess is what's going on with that, because I'm not the editor.
Yeah.
But the new wheel doesn't spin for as long.
That's true.
There might not be time to hold on a wide. Mm-hmm. And when it stops, it doesn't slow down the new one. It stops pretty quick.
Yeah.
And you want it to stop in the close-up.
Oh, absolutely, because then you get that...
Yeah, people can see what it landed on.
Everybody feels our surprise. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
But the new wheel isn't like a special rigged wheel. We wouldn't need that to rig it. We really wouldn't.
No, you... It would be far easier to rig it. It is not rigged. Okay, so Maya... After this tantalizing cliffhanger, will you let me be your lawyer? Let's fight this one and get you out of here.
Right! Thank you! All my negativity, but now for plot reasons, I'm super excited!
Also remember that you have no choice. I'm doing this whether you like it or not.
You are the man, and my cult does tell me that I have to listen to everything a man tells me.
That's right. That's right. She smiled, at least. She looks like an entirely different person. It's almost as if her mask is coming off, and her true reptilian form is coming through. Wait, one, before you transform completely, one last question. You are innocent, right?
What the fuck, man? We just went through all this shit, and you're gonna pull that card on me now? When's the state-appointed defense attorney getting here? I don't want this guy! And I trust you.
Oh, sorry.
So you trust me too, okay?
It's a deal. So, what's next? There's something that's been bugging me. Hoop. Maybe she has polio. Maybe she... Just what was inside that strange woman's drawer? It was when I tried to look in the drawer that she got all defensive. There has to be something in there. I guess I'll break the law. Break into her apartment. Nope. Oh. What? Oh, her phone. Wait. I got your phone. Hey, I got your cell phone back. You're welcome.
Oh, say, can I listen to my sister's voice?
That's depressing. What? What?
I don't want her to delete it.
Why would she want to delete it?
I don't know. Maya's eyes closed. She listened to every word with such intensity before long tears began to roll down her cheeks. With every bitch, her heart seemed to flutter a little bit. If you remember, her sister called her a bitch a lot. Rich! Did you fall asleep last we talked? Says I'm Kenny Powers. My explanation of X-Men Apocalypse must have been boring you.
I thought we were done talking.
You know, reviews for Apocalypse have already been coming out. They've lifted the what do you call it?
I'm not sure what you call it.
When like a movie company or game company says you can't release reviews until a certain time, they've lifted that already, the review ban.
Word's already hit the street.
Oh, yeah, no, and people are saying overwhelmingly negative things about it.
Yeah.
It's just weird, though, that they would do that.
Embargo.
Embargo, thank you.
Dick Neutral.
Thank you, Dick Neutral. That's the embargo. That's exactly the word I was looking for. All right. We can't talk. All of the stuff has a check mark on it.
Okay.
So I guess we move.
I just want to show her more things. Do we have new things to show?
That just makes her sad.
Show her the autopsy report.
This is a bad idea.
Sorry. I've never seen that before. Oh, God.
You know, because my sister's never been dead before.
What a horrible death.
I think I'm going to go try to get back to that Biddy's apartment. Ooh, hello, bellboy.
Alfred.
Good afternoon, sir. Excuse me, you are? Oh, I beg your pardon, sir. I am the bellboy of this establishment. At your service, sir. Oh, right. I've just come up to deliver the room service, sir. Do you know where Miss May might be? Ah, I believe our guest Miss May is currently using her, she's taking a shit. No way to put it lightly. That little lady likes to shit. She's in there twice a day. Poop, poop, poop. Plop, plop, plop.
Little round pellets, strangely enough. Then she's eating them.
This is what rabbits do.
They eat their own poop?
Yeah.
What? What?
Yeah.
Why do they eat their own poop?
To make sure they get the nutrients? I'm not nature.
Touche, Rich Evans.
If you've no need of anything, I'll be taking my leave. I hope that when I leave this room, I do not fall. But it's all right. Because what happens when we fall, Mr. Wright? What happens? We get up. We get back up. I'm going to leave now. Please, stay as long as you like. Yes, I'll do that. Wait, no, hey. Why does it seem like every time I come here, I end up embarrassing myself? Wait, now's my chance to snooper. Oh, I almost forgot. Wait, what moment. I know you were probably going to snoop around a bit, but I almost forgot. Gah, you came back quick. Might I ask you to inform Miss May that there is a message for her, yeah? Please, tell her that Mr. White of Blue Corp phoned. Mr. White. Just gonna put that in bold right there. Mr. White. I'm not sure if you've heard that name before. I reckon you have not. Because why would you? White's also a pretty normal name. Oh, right. Sure, I'll let her know. Mr. White of Blue Corp. White, blue, so many colors. I'm red with anger. Oh, another color. Damn you, Crayola!
Recycled toilet paper? Has this building gone green?
Oh, they flash back to her saying white. She said that 2 seconds ago.
Rich. TNG After Dark says, Rich, would you say you were delighted by Mike's couch lift? It was. I had a drink on there. Not a big deal. I just got another drink.
I wanted him to go full tip, though. Like, he seemed to wuss out. He seemed to wuss out over the couch thing.
Yeah, probably would have ended up breaking the table or something fucked up.
Yeah, probably. Oh, sorry. This is a flashback. So, yeah, that's fine.
Oh.
All right. White was the name of the guy who ruined Mia and Maya's mother. Maybe he murdered Mia and Maya's mother.
Mia Maya murder?
My oh my!
Mia Maya murder mother? Motherfucker!
It's moot. Could it be a coincidence? Well, fuck, look in the drawer.
What kind of lawyer are you? Of course it's not a coincidence!
A screwdriver sticking out of that half-open drawer. Now's my chance to see what's inside. What do we have here? A wiretap. What would a woman be doing with a thing like this? I mean, does she even know how it works? I think I've been hanging around with that cop for too long. Oh, and I guess I'll just steal that.
It is now completely inadmissible. It is now
Mr. Wright, how do we have any proof that was in the witness's hotel room? You pulled it out of your pocket.
Say this search warrant is unwarranted.
Ooh. There is definitely something suspicious about this Miss May. Why would she have something like this in her hotel room? There's a story behind all of this. I know it. All right. I'll be using this bit of evidence in tomorrow's trial. That's for sure. What? Phoenix is the worst lawyer ever.
I am also going to type out a confession and hand that to the judge.
I'm gonna make her sign it right in front of the judge. I might have to smack her around a little bit. I'm sure that will be fine. For Maya's sake, I'll get to this woman's bottom. Oh, wait. I get it.
I'm Kenny Powers, says. Kenny fucking Powers returns. Richard, can you announce this? Mason Lee, I'm coming for you, motherfucker.
Let's give that a little more.
Well, I'm gonna... Mason Lee, I'm coming for you, motherfucker!
Who's Mason Lee?
I don't know. Somebody knows.
Okay, great.
Someone Kenny fucking Powers knows. That's obvious. Specifically who it is. This is less obvious, but we don't need to know.
Oh, okay. Oh my god, that's not your name. Who is that?
What?
Oh, I'm just wondering. I'm hoping someone in the chat says who that is.
Probably a message they're going to play for someone to know. A friend would be my guess. Oh, that's okay. A big deal.
The audio will be used in court, right?
Phoenix Wright's going to use it as evidence to frame us. Your Honor, I have this recording of Rich Evans saying, Mason Lee, I'm coming for you, motherfucker.
Oh, he's at a pro.
Oh, pal boy, still there?
Time to scram. I look forward to tangoing with you tomorrow, Miss May. Horizontal. In court, I mean. Oh, shit. To be.
Done.
Save. Yes. Saving.
September 7th, 10 a.m. District Court, courtroom number 1.
Here it is. Here's the trial.
We ready for this, Rich?
This game's kind of neat.
You got? We're dicking around and we're joking around. Like, I think I can see why this is a popular series.
Yeah.
This would be a fun. This is a perfect mobile game. Well, you pick up some evidence, put it down for a little bit, pick it back up, do some stuff. I agree. This is a fun.
Court is now in session for the trial of Miss Maya Faye. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor. Miles Edgeworth, I'd better not show any signs of weakness today, or he'll be on me in an instant.
Mr. Edgeworth, please give the court your opening statement.
Oh, thank you, Your Honor. The defendant, Miss Maya Faye, was at the scene of the crime.
I like this voice for this guy. He's so cool and pompous. He's like,
Your Honor.
I would like to eat buttered toast.
Sorry. When do we break for lunch?
Sorry. Did you read this already? I got confused. Okay, here we go.
The prosecution has evidence she committed this murder. We have a witness who saw her do it. Prosecution sees no reason to doubt the facts. This case.
I'm losing it. I'm already losing it.
The prosecution has no reason to doubt this case here, Your Honor.
I see. Thank you, Mr. Edgeworth. Let's begin, then.
We may call our first witness, Your Honor. The prosecution calls chief officer at the scene, Detective Gumshoe.
Oh, I get it. You were bumbling.
Yeah. Bonds. My name is Bonds.
Witness, please state your name and profession to the court.
Sir. My name is Sonny Bonds, sir. I'm the detective in charge of homicides down at the precinct, sir.
Detective Gumshoe, please describe for us the details of the murder.
Is this
murder, right?
I don't know.
I got it confused. I got a traffic accident at 7. You mean it's 10? I missed the traffic? Oh, God. Which murder is this?
Very well, sir. Let me use this floor map of the office to explain.
The body was found by this window here.
Oh, interesting.
And the cause of death? Oh, I'm just kidding. Loss of blood due to being struck by a blunt object.
Oh, gee.
Oh, the murder weapon was a statue of the thinker found next to the body. It was heavy enough to be a deadly weapon, even in a girl's hands. Serendipity. Seren fucking dippity.
It's so beautiful when it accidentally fits together like that. It's just so beautiful, Rich.
The court accepts the statue as evidence.
I took it out of Phoenix Wright's pocket. He's been carrying it this whole time, by the way. No, nothing.
It's actually a very close replica to the actual murder weapon, as Phoenix Wright showed me one. I went to the dollar store, and I bought another statue of the thinker.
They're still calling it a statue.
It's a clock.
What?
If you remember, it's a clock. It tells the time.
Mr. Fancy Pants Lawyer with your facts.
Yes.
Detective.
Yes?
You immediately arrested Miss Faye, who's found at the scene, correct? Can you tell me why?
Because she was the murder suspect. Why do you think I arrested her? She was there.
Because she was jaywalking.
She was there. Somebody had to commit the crime. I had hard evidence she did it.
Ross, Detective Gumshoe. Please testify to the court about this hard evidence.
And I will only say this once to the entire court. No boner jokes.
You're probably better for the judge.
Yep.
Is my guess.
Yep.
But
you're already in it. I said go for it. I'm sure I'm going to have a ton of shit later, so.
Oh, here we go. Witness testimony. My face rest. Okay.
As soon as the phone call came in, I rushed to the scene after stopping to get donuts and the strip club. There were two people there already in the 4 hours it took me to get to the crime scene. The defendant, Miss Maya Fay, and the lawyer, Mr. Phoenix Wright. Maya? Her name's Maya? Not whatever. Look, she's a criminal, as far as I'm concerned. I immediately arrested Mrs. Maya Fay. Why? We had a witness account describing her. Some kind of bunny rabbit woman. Weirdest fucking thing I've ever seen in my life. She just holds her hands up to her chest.
I'm just looking in the, you know, because at any point I can, you know, objection. I can do the thing. I don't think I can do a thing yet.
Kind of holds her hands up like a bunny and it squeezes her tits together. The cleavage is, it's magnificent. Her hair's really pink, though. The witness saw Mrs. Maya Fay at the very moment of the murder. Go ahead.
I'm looking. We don't have any evidence. We don't have any evidence to call objection on this for. He mentioned something about, like, not possibly not being able to see out of her window, but there's nothing I have in here.
He said not being able to see a face.
Right.
What's the photograph?
Oh, that's the floor plan.
Maybe use the floor plan?
Also, I can't. Maybe I can't make objections at this point. Alright.
You have to hear the testimony first.
Oh, okay.
Should I keep doing the judge, or do you want to do the judge? I think you're a better judge than me, but...
Well, I can be the judge. You want me to be like an old man?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
the very moment you say. It's Admiral Akbar. It's a trap. That's my judge voice. Very well, Mr. Wright. You may begin your cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor. Cross-examination? What? What? Who? Where am I? I should not have done all of those drugs this morning. I couldn't see a single contradiction in that testimony. Whoosh! What?
Did you just say whoosh?
Nothing, nothing, nothing. What? Hey, Maya just threw... Oh, okay, that makes way more sense than someone just threw something at you. Yes. This, when my sister couldn't find any contradictions in a witness's testimony, she would bluff it and press the witness on every detail. The witness always slips up and says something wrong. It worked lots of times. Hey, I should have expected Maya would know some of her sister's tricks. All right, let's give this a try! Lying!
Is something the matter?
No, Your Honor. I'd like to begin my cross-examination.
Bing! As soon as the phone call came in, I rushed to the scene. After stopping for donuts and a strip club.
So I can present evidence or I could press him on it, but I mean, that's fairly normal. We'll let that go.
Or you could press...
Huh?
You can press time and time.
All right.
Hold it! Who did you say you got a call from? And don't you fucking say the Ghostbusters.
Hey, pal, don't play dumb. You know who. The call was from a customer at the Gateway Hotel, right across from the crime scene.
Okay, I pressed. Not sure it did much, though. Right, please continue.
There were two people there already.
Two people there. Hey, well, I mean, that, there's nothing really to press him.
No.
So, okay, all right.
The defendant, Miss Maya Fey, and the lawyer, Mr. Phoenix Wright.
That is very accurate.
I immediately arrested Miss Maya Fey.
Whoosh, press!
Hold it!
Why is that? What's your reason? What's your angle?
Why? We had a witness account describing it.
Pressing again.
Hold it!
Hold it just 1 second.
What?
If I heard correctly, you said you arrested her because you had hard evidence. She did it, correct?
Well, I'm sure I put some there. Did I say that? I want to talk to my lawyer.
You don't have one. I heard you say it.
Yes, you said it.
You said it.
Exactly what about this suspicious woman in pink's claim is hard evidence, mister?
You're into it, Jack. I like that.
I like feeling.
What?
I like it. You know, it's like over... Someone was, I don't know if it was on Twitter or somewhere, but they were just like, I'm surprised you like Phoenix, right? It's like, I like campy, mm-hmm. as long as it's, like, purposefully campy. This seems like it's purposefully campy, you know?
Why do they think you wouldn't like it is the question.
A lot of dialogue, but it's also like being a little detective, and I like being a detective.
Yeah.
So, okay.
Well, it's not dialogue getting in the way of the game. It's dialogue that
is
the game.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, yeah, what?
Miss May isn't suspicious. And she sure isn't pink, pal. I've checked. The carpet doesn't match the drapes. It's all a lie.
That's enough, Detective Gumshoe. Do you have any more solid proof other than her claims, Detective?
Well, let me see.
I guess pressing can have its advantages.
Well, yes.
Oh, shit.
Yes, I do.
Grr.
Sorry, I got the order of things mixed up in my testimony, Your Honor, sir. Here's what really maybe kind of happened. There was something I should have told you about first, your Honor. Yes, yes!
Very well, Detective. Let's hear your testimony again.
Oh, yeah. I see you're changing the story, huh? Mm-hmm. No, that's fine.
After securing the suspect, I examined the scene of the crime with my own eyes. I found a memo written on a piece of paper next to the victim's body. On it, the word Maya was written clearly in blood.
Damn it. Damn it!
Lab test results showed that the blood was the victim's. Also, there was blood found on the victim's finger. Before she died, the victim wrote the killer's name.
Oh, they cut to a wide shot. That's pretty. That means we can't hear the game right now, but I can only assume that was like a dun dun dun.
How do you like that for hard evidence, Mr. Fancy Pants McLawyer?
Before we begin cross-examination, I have a question for you, Detective.
Your Honor.
Why didn't you testify about this vital piece of evidence the first time?
Because I'm a cop? I don't know. I guess I just forgot, Your Honor. Look, I put the people in jail. That's what I do. That's what I did. What do you want from me? Evidence.
Try to be more careful. Very well. The defense may begin its cross-examination. But be careful. I can't help it. It sounds exactly like Admiral Akbar. And I'm trying to remember.
It's fine.
Okay.
It's fine.
All right. Hard evidence.
After securing the suspect, I examined the scene of the crime with my own eyes. Technically, Felix Wright did.
I was going to say, we showed him that. Is that something we should press him on? But I mean, he just said he inspected the scene of the crime with his own eyes. You know?
Okay.
I'm going to let that one go.
I found a memo written on a piece of paper next to the victim's body.
Okay.
You
found
it.
That definitely didn't happen. I'm going to press him on that. Hold it.
Just because you found it next to the body doesn't... Well, Phoenix, also you can be like, also I gave that to you outside of the office. There is literally no way you could know this.
Then who did write it, Mr. Smarty Pants?
What? Who?
I did. No.
The killer.
Yeah.
The killer. Anyone can see that.
Well, you're saying that the killer wrote her own name? Oh, buddy, please.
Nice, cop.
I watched Columbo once or twice.
I mean, the sound was off.
While I was drunk. I know how this works.
She was framed.
Objection. Oh, shit. I got an objection called on me.
Hold on there. If that's the case, where's your evidence?
Irk.
Yeah, hey, I guess a bit of a tall order for you. One that... those without evidence shouldn't open their mouths, Mr. Wright.
Yeah, pal.
Well, Detective, tell us what was written on that memo you found there.
I did the word Maya, written clearly in blood. Human blood.
All right.
Red blood. Lab test results showed that the blood was the victim's.
I mean, there's really nothing we can press on that.
There was.
Oh, wait, we can go back.
She died instantly. The autopsy report. BAM! BAM, motherfucker!
Objection! Detective Gumshoe, there's one thing I want you to clarify for me here.
Ah, no! The mic! The mic has ruined our high five!
Rich! You say that the victim, Mia Faye, wrote this note!
Oh, I love the hand thing, too.
Yep. That she was accusing the defendant, Mia Faye. That's really what you're saying?
What? This isn't one of those lawyer tricks now, is it? Cause she wrote it. Who else could have?
Mm-mm-mm. You have it backwards, detective.
Backwards?
I've heard this word before.
What? It means something.
The victim is the only person who absolutely could not have written it. Ooh. This is a report from your department, detective. Immediate death due to a blow from a blunt object.
Bam! Oh.
She died immediately!
But,
No butting your way out of this one, detective. Ooh, the wide shot. The wide shot. We got the wide shot.
Order. The detective has a point. Someone who died immediately wouldn't have the time to write anything down.
Objection! Oh, sorry, that wasn't my objection.
Mr. Wright, there, I beg your pardon, but, what exactly did you obtain that autopsy report?
Who cares? It's already in the system. It's legal. It's legal, isn't it?
When? We got it the day after the murder.
Yep.
Yeah.
It was the day after the murder.
The prosecution's point being...
An autopsy...
It was like Kermity.
I gotta get it all...
It was
close
almost,
off the back of my throat.
It was almost a lethal...
The autopsy report is outdated, Your Honor.
What?
Second autopsy was performed yesterday at my request.
Son of a bitch.
Death was almost immediate due to a blow from a blunt object. But there is possibility the victim lived for several minutes after the blow, I think. I received these results this morning.
No way!
Your Honor, it's quite easy to imagine that the victim did have time to write a Maya. That is all.
What a dickhead. What a dickhead. Who's withholding evidence now? I mean, it's still me.
I see.
Damn you, Edgeworth. I should have known you would have something up your sleeve.
Why, Mr. Wright? You look shocked.
Yes, I'm shocked that you didn't share evidence when you are legally obliged to share all your evidence.
Not in fantasy court, bitch. No. Something you want to say, Mr. Wright?
I'm a sham!
You're a sham. Edgeworth, the detective is the real sham here. But, I mean... I don't like that these are my only options.
Well, who would be a sham? What would make somebody a sham?
A sham? A sham is like something that's not correct and not real, right?
A scam. A dishonest. Right. And how do we prove it?
Well, Edgeworth is saying like, we just don't know if it's immediate. So the possibility is true. So Edgeworth is spinning it right.
Out of these options... What do we have?
I'd say the detective.
Yes.
Okay. Detective Gumshoe. Because I'm not calling you by your given name. You're a sham! How could you give me a faulty report?
Oh no!
Yeah.
This is gonna go poorly. What? I thought...
Detective Gumshoe.
My name's Sonny Bonds. And I just said that strange herb. Herb, without a B. Herb. I said it. Like Will Smith trying to say Uranus or something. I don't know. Welcome to Herb.
By the way, look at Edgeworth. Throwing you under the bus. Throwing you under the fucking bus.
I'm disappointed in you handing him the wrong report like that. Oh.
Hey, I'm sorry.
You are at the fault there, detective. Yes. This isn't going to look good on your evaluation next month.
What?
Your Honor, I submit this report to the court.
Understood. The court accepts the evidence. Ah, autopsy report. There it is. In the court records. I say from Detective C.P.
Mother. Well, Your Honor, yeah. Oh, hey.
Oh, sorry.
The evidence strongly suggests the victim was identifying the killer.
I suppose that's the obvious conclusion. Case closed.
Darn, this isn't good.
The prosecution would like to call its next witness.
I think we handled that as best we could.
Unless he was a sham for not sharing the evidence with us.
I mean, we shamed the detective.
Well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
This poor innocent girl saw the murder with her own eyes.
Oh, rumph,
rumph, rumph, rumph, rumph.
Let the witness... Nice, I promise. Take your time.
Exactly what part of her is innocent, Gear. Okay, so... Wait.
Beyond her... Well, I'll wait till it gets back to her.
Witness your name, please.
I promise.
Holy shit, her boobs just bounced.
At your service.
So, beyond the fact... I mean, that she's being a cat again.
Yeah.
She clearly said she was going to pretty herself up for court, yet she is wearing the exact same outfit and no extra makeup or hair did. She's a sham.
Oh, look at her standing there, too, from the wide.
Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, apparently the crowd went nuts for that one.
Order! An introduction should not require any reaction from the crowd. The witness will refrain from wanton winking. Whatever that is.
Oh, yes, Your Honor.
This is not good. She's already captured the heart of every man in this courtroom.
Tell us where you were on the night of September 5th when the murder occurred.
Oh, gee, I was, like, in my hotel room. I brought my harness back up. I checked in right after lunch.
And this hotel is directly across from the Fay and Co. law offices.
That's right, big boy.
Please testify to the court about what you saw. I am done with your shenanigans.
Witness testimony.
It was like 9 at night. I looked out the window, you know? And then, ooh, I saw a woman with long hair being attacked. The one attacking her was the Mazda girl sitting in the defendant's chair. Then the woman, she like dodged to one side and ran away. But that girl... She c- caught up to her and she hit her. Then that woman went long higher. She kind of slumped. The end. That's all I saw. Every little bitsy witsy.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Can we go over her testimony again? Is that an option?
Well, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, like, we'll next we go through piece by piece, okay. And that's when we can object to evidence and stuff. There's nothing we can do during that part. Just listen.
Well, Your Honor.
I see. It is a remarkably solid testimony. I don't see a need to trouble the witness.
Jesus fucking Christ, Your Honor. Let's get one thing straight.
Oh, what? What do you want? You're still here? I thought we already convicted it. Oh, sorry. What about my cross-examination? I thought the witness's testimony was just quite firm.
Really? We're going that way?
Mr. Wright, I understand you were Mrs. Mia Fey's understudy, were you not? You must know her techniques well. How her cowardly way of finding tiny faults and perfectly good testimonies.
Hey, how dare you? Well, Mr. Wright, will you cross-examine the witness?
Well, of course I'm gonna fucking cross-examine the witness.
I'll gladly proceed with the cross-examination!
If only because I have a good... have a feeling Edgeworth doesn't want me to. She has to have some weakness. I know. I'll unzip my pants a little bit.
Very well. You may begin your cross-examination. And may the force be with you. Be with all of us.
Okay, here we go.
It was like 9 at night. I looked out the window, you know? Now let's look at the autopsy report. When did she die?
Died from a blow by a bone object. May have lived for a few minutes. It doesn't say.
Doesn't say time.
Doesn't say time at that.
The phone.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
9:27 a.m.
Right. And then she said... She said, come to my house at 9. Oh, yeah, here. At the back here. See you tonight at 9. I haven't called in a while. Well, actually, there's something I want you to hold on for me. What was that even? Okay. Wait, I wonder if I can... No, we can't check the autopsy report. Attorney's badge, autopsy report, made a cell phone, glass shards. The thinker, the murder weapon looks like a statue, but it's actually a clock. The wiretap, which, you know, we can present at any time. A receipt. We also don't know, like, what is on the back of this receipt. I don't know if that matters.
Don't think it does.
The floor plan, which, you know, could be vital. Like, obviously, this is where the window is.
Oh, that's the visual spectrum there.
Yeah. So, like, here's the field of view that she can see.
She wouldn't see the chair.
She wouldn't see the chair.
She wouldn't see the breaking of that glass thing, stand, whatever it was.
Right. It looks like the altercation happened over here. Over by the chair, and so she wouldn't see any of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to catch her up on the time. Is there anything we can prove with time?
I don't think there's anything we can prove with the time. But, like, we can still press her and see what happens. See what we can shake loose.
Wait, do you lose points or anything?
I have no idea, Rich. We have these exclamation marks on top?
Yeah.
Maybe we use one when we press?
Maybe.
I don't know.
Press every statement. It's free info. Okay.
Oh, okay. Why did you do that?
Huh? Why? Like, why what?
Why did you look out the window? Were you expecting to see something?
Oh, well, gee.
What? That's it? Did you get...
I sort of, you know, Look at my tits.
I had a feeling, is what she said. Sorry, I clicked on it before. Well, I have a feeling she's trying to avoid the question. Maybe I should press a little harder on this one.
Yeah, go for it.
Okay. See how far I can run with this. Surely you must have had a reason to look out the window at that time of night.
Ow!
Objection!
Nope. Mr. Wright, I will not have you badgering my witness.
I'm sorry that asking a question is badgering, you dick. But badgering?
You insist on needling her with these trivial questions. I really don't think it should be allowed. Yeah.
Obviously.
It's like the Crown.
Yeah.
Order! Mr. Wright, you have been warned! The tits get the floor! Get back off! Poor girl, what about poor me?
Yeah, you looked out the window, what did you see next?
And then, oh! Saw a woman with long hair being attacked!
Yeah, I guess if we can press her. The woman with long hair was Mia Fey. Oh, sorry. Oh, I thought that was in my head.
Uh-huh. Slender, sort of. Well, some people might say pretty, if that's your thing.
Your thing? What a cunt.
And that person attacking her?
The one attacking her was the mousy girl sitting in the defendant's chair.
Hold it! How do you know she was the defendant?
Huh? Well, no. She had a girlish physique. Women know these things. Look, I'm a bunny.
God damn it. The bunny defense.
Aren't
it's impenetrable.
Aren't I a cute bunny?
There's only one person at the scene of the crime with a short girlish figure.
I mean, have you seen me? I'm slender as fuck.
The testimony is bulletproof, Your Honor.
I question the testimony. Hold on a minute. That testimony stinks!
What?
Miss May, I'm willing to bet that... You saw nothing, and then we'll show the photograph, is what I'm thinking. Or you're lying because of the wiretap. Wait, sorry. The exclamation marks are your health, by the way. You lose them for every wrong piece of evidence and a few other times when the judge asks you something direct. Oh, okay.
I'm going with you saw nothing.
Show the room? Don't trust the chat. They lie all the times. Don't look at
Actually, I've looked over. They're saying you're lying.
I know.
I'm saying you saw nothing.
But they lie all the time, so maybe it is you saw nothing.
Go for you. They saw nothing.
That's where I'd go.
Just do it. Just do it.
You saw
just
nothing.
Get it over with.
Yep. I'm willing to bet. Did you really see the defendant at all? Oh, we got the wide shot.
Mr. Wright, what is the meaning of this?
Yes, what is the meaning? Somebody tell me because I'm clueless about this. I mean...
Okay. If you had really witnessed my client, Mia Fey, you would have noticed her clothes before noticing her physique. That's right, she wears, like, the robes.
Okay.
Eee! Look, oh yeah, that's right. No one wears clothes like this on a daily basis except her, and it hides her womanly physique. Look at that.
Yeah.
Look at her. All up. You can't, it's like all up in here. You can't see it. And I'm no expert on fashion, but her hairdo looks far less or looks far from normal to me. However, the witness's testimony mentions neither of these things. Boom!
More like pop.
Huh?
It's not a boom.
Yeah. It's a chink.
Okay.
Chink.
Okay.
The testimony is bogus!
It's a chip.
It's a chip.
But...
Still, we don't know if she was dressed that way on the night of the murder. She was, Your Honor. I saw her. Remember, I was there too, yet I am able to be her lawyer. Hey, does no one remember that I was there the night of the murder? And so did Detective Gumshoe. Yes. What do you say to that, Miss May?
Rawr! I'm a cat now!
God damn you, bunny cat! The perfect defense. The bunny cat defense. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
That's all I'm
okay,
gonna say.
Great.
I saw what I saw.
Oh, boom. Boom.
I just didn't think all the trifling details were necessary, darling.
Yes, May. The court would like to remind you to please omit nothing in your testimony.
Shit, girl.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. Look at me lick this. I could be your cock.
Oh, what? Oh, yes, it's cute. who did you want to lose again? Because I will make sure that happens. Your testimony again. If you would.
Damn, I almost had her. So now she gets a second chance to test phony.
Might get more information that we can discredit. I did see everything. I did. The victim, the woman, dodged the first attack and ran off to the right. BAM!
We are so fucking on to you. Oh, really? Ran off to the right? Ran off to the right? Oh, what's that? What's that over there on the right? No fucking damage. We can't, you know, use that.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck yeah. Oh, you're so done. You're so done, Tits McGee.
Then the girl in the hippie clothes ran after her.
The hippie clothes.
And she hit her with that weapon. I saw it. I did. That clock, that statue with clock, the thinker, I think.
The clock? No one knows it's a clock.
Well, does the accuracy of my report not startle you? Tee-hee! Tee-hee!
I see. I only wish you had been so detailed from the beginning. Please, begin the cross-examination.
Okay.
I did see everything. I did. The victim, the woman, dodged first attack, ran off to the right.
Oh man, if only I had some evidence I could present. Present.
Objection! This evidence clearly reveals the contradiction in that statement, Your Honor.
How exactly are that evidence and the statement now related?
They aren't. Wait.
What?
Did I get... What?
Not a...
I gave the picture, right? Off to the right.
Well, you don't want to lose another health.
No. I'm just... That's the one I gave him. Press first, present later. That's bullshit. Oh, okay. Maybe she meant like... Oh.
Okay, okay.
Hold on.
That's kind of bullshit, but...
Hold on. We'll see. Is that right, as in your right, as you looked from the hotel?
Which hand do I hold my knife in again? Right. It was my right hand, right?
You satisfied, Mr. Wright? Please continue.
Can I give this to him yet? No. I can't give it to him yet. So now...
Yeah, now I present.
Objection! Okay, Your Honor, I know we did this like 2 seconds ago, but the statement contradicts the evidence.
Hmm? It does?
Well, maybe we show him.
Sorry, you're right.
I don't see anything contradictory. Huh? Really? Object...
Music continues to play. It means you No! We have evidence! We fucking have evidence! She say he went right, she went left.
Maybe the broken pieces of the thing rather than the photo. We're using the wrong thing. We know what happened because of the photo, but maybe the proof is more the shattered glass. Try it with the glass. Try it with the shattered pieces.
We only have 3 more exclamation points.
I know.
Hold on, they say I can save. Save game and suspend play?
No, we want to keep playing.
Did I save, though? I don't know. All right, hold on. The victim, the woman, dodged the first attack and ran off to the right.
Well, what's in her evidence again?
So I see in the chat. No, she said right as if she was looking from the hotel.
Yeah.
Absolutely, she did. We pressed her on that. Okay, we have the autopsy report. We have the cell phone with the conversation. We have the glass shards, the broken glass remains of the bosun and Lysand, broken beyond all recognition. We have the thinker.
I'm also being told we didn't save.
The wiretap. The receipt. And the floor plans. Okay, hold on. Well, first, then... Oh, back. And then we continue, I guess. From safe. Okay. Okay. So the question is... Well, I guess we save now, so we get a freebie.
I'd feel bad reloading if it doesn't work, though.
Right. They're saying press again.
Sure.
Is that right as in your right as you looked from the hotel? Which hand do I hold my knife in again?
All of us.
Right. It was my right hand. Right. That time is right. Then the girl in the hippie clothes ran after. I don't know, Rich. What do you want to do?
We didn't always go back, right?
Yeah.
Well, what else? What's...
Well, let's
press
on that. A clock? Didn't this come up in another testimony recently?
Well, don't look so sour, Mr. Lawyer. You can't win them all.
No, but I have a feeling I'm onto something now.
That clock, that kind of statue with clock thinker, I think?
Yeah, but
present.
Present the clock?
Fuck it.
Miss May, what you just said now was quite revealing.
Revealing? Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? Naughty, Mr. Lawyer.
You just said that this statue of the thinker was a clock. But there's no way of knowing that just by looking at it.
Erp.
Another person in much the same position as you recently called this a clock, too. And he was found guilty of murder. Ooh, harumph, 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 harumph. Order! Order! Miss May, can you explain how you know this was a clock?
Oh, erp. Erp.
The witness saw the murder with her own eyes. That's all that's important here. The defense is trying to confuse the issue with trivial concerns, Your Honor.
Yes, yes, of course. You will withdraw the question.
You're right. Of course, Tits gets the floor.
Objection! Oh, whoa, oh no, I'm objecting
the objection! This is a three objection!
But questions are all I have, Your Honor. And as you may recall, I've caught murderers with these questions before.
Well, only once.
Objection sustained. You may continue to question the witness.
Whew, that was close. Stop me there, the trial would be over.
Huh? What? So what happens now?
What happens now is you answer my questions. How did you know it was a clock?
What? Because I heard it?
Oh, damn.
Yes, I heard it say the time.
Bitch, you done fried yourself!
So, you've been to the law offices of Fay and Company.
I didn't say that. Why would I go there? I heard from my hotel room.
And the law offices of Fay and Co., where the murder took place, is very close to the hotel. She could easily have heard the clock.
Well, Mr. Wright, are you satisfied?
Fuck no, Judge. No, Your Honor. I can't give up now. I'm not satisfied because...
It couldn't have... It's broke, right? Isn't there something wrong with it? I recall somebody saying there was something wrong with it. It couldn't have rung.
Your Honor, members of the court, it is inconceivable that the clock in question rang.
Fuck.
It's broken.
They said to stuff it with papers or something? The mechanics are out of it. It's empty.
It's empty. It's empty. That clock is missing. It's clockwork.
Now that's a boom.
How could you possibly?
Just take a look right now. See anything interesting, Your Honor?
It is as the defense says. This clock is missing. It's clockwork. It's quite empty. Mr. Wright, would you care to explain to the court the meaning of this?
It is as you can see. That doesn't seem like it should be a sentence.
It is as you can see. It is as you can see.
Oh, I know. It's just like, it's all very small words.
Yeah. Okay, that's what you mean. Yeah.
The clock was empty. It couldn't have rung. Therefore, this witness is a big, fat, whorish, did I mention fat liar?
Fat?
Well, Miss May.
Tisk tisk here. In quite a show you've put on for us, Mr. Wright.
He knew the clock was empty. Somehow he knew.
I'm afraid you've forgotten one thing, however. Indeed, the clock is empty, as you say. It can't ring. However, we must ask, when was the clockwork removed?
We have this evidence. We have this evidence.
If it was after the witness heard the clock, then there is no contradiction. Yeah? Huh?
Who?
Huh?
Who? Oh, maybe I still got a shot with tits. That is true. That is a possibility. The clock might have been emptied after she heard it.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened, Your Honor. Yeah.
Well, Mr. Wright, can you prove when the clock was removed?
Oh, impossible, of course.
I have proof, but he'll have to wait until after we stand up. It's stand-up time. It's time to stand up and stretch your legs. Oh, geez. Rich is knocking stuff over. For stand-up time.
Ow! Ow! Oh, it hurts every time. And that's why we stand up.
Okay, are you ready for the thrilling conclusion? I am. Ah. Stand up for evidence. That's right. Stand up for evidence. Stand up for justice.
Harumph.
Okay, we have the... Oh, wait. Maybe my stylish.
Rich, we have the proof.
Yep.
What? Oh my!
Wasn't it you who told me proof is everything? Well, I was listening, and now I'll show you the proof you like so much.
The evidence that proves when the clockwork was removed is Maya's cell phone. Just to double check. You haven't called in a while. Well, actually, there's something I want. It's a clock. It's made to look like a statue of the thinker, and it tells you the time. I should probably tell you the clock isn't talking right now. It's not working. That's lame. Okay. Yep. It is definitely the phone.
Take that!
Take that! Take a look at this.
Ha! Huh, that's a very cute cell phone.
Judge, might I say that's highly inappropriate.
No, where did you get that? I think I would like it. Ooh, is that strap a collector's item?
Remember? That's a callback. Callback from the...
Oh, you have a girly phone. Ooh, I like what? It.
Wait, fine. Wait, no. Shut up, tits. Calm them. Calm your tits. Listen.
But they jiggle so much.
Calm them. Please calm them.
Every time I try to get them in order, it just jiggles more.
Court files in favor of the lady with the tits.
Listen. This is the defendant's cell phone, and it contains a recording. A recording of a conversation she had with the victim on the day of the murder. Harumph.
Order. Order!
Defendant's cell phone, this wasn't brought to my attention.
Oh, kind of like the autopsy report, you son of a bitch. Is that... was that autopsy report brought to my attention? Oh.
yes! Oh, I'm sorry. Perhaps Detective Gumshoe overlooked it. Snap.
Well, the good detective better remember he's up for reevaluation soon.
I gotta say, I'm starting to feel bad for the big fella. Let's hear the conversation.
Beep.
We know this. If you could. Tell you the clock isn't talking right now. It's not working. That's lame. I had to take the clockwork out. Sorry. September 5th, 9:27 a.m. Beep.
Your Honor, I think this makes it clear the clockwork was already gone by the time this was recorded. Which was well before the witness even arrived at her hotel.
Meow?
Well, Miss May, would you care to explain this to the court? Just how did you know this weapon was a clock?
Isn't it obvious? I saw that clock before. What store is that again? I go to so many stores.
This was a custom-made clock. I remember this from our last. There's only two of these clocks in existence.
Oops, I forgot. Look at my tits.
Yep, look at my tits.
Oh, okay, so the witness, yep, witness is clear. She's seen it before. For some reason, I believe her. Hold on, I'm mopping up my drool. That would make sense. Does the defense have any objections?
Yes. Yes.
The witness claims she had seen it before, but this directly contradicts a piece of evidence already submitted to this court.
Well then, that's it.
Oh. What? Do I just...
Can we scroll? Is there any other evidence?
This is all the evidence. The thinker, made by Larry Butts. I'll just present the statue.
Okay.
That's the evidence.
Okay.
Please produce this evidence that will prove the witness had not seen the clock before. It's made by Larry Butts.
Okay.
Present.
Take that! It's simple. This clock was never in any store, ever.
What?
A friend of mine made that clock. Only two exist in the world.
Oh, see, that's neat. You have to kind of remember the last case, too.
Yeah.
And the one that isn't here is in police custody.
Impossible. Everything is sold in stores.
Miss May, I think it's high time you went shopping for a better excuse.
Boom.
This game is adorable.
Huh?
This game is adorable. It I is approve adorable. Of
you,
Phoenix Wright.
You should approve of Phoenix Wright.
Humph.
Oh, excuses not on sale today.
Ha ha!
Whoa!
What's it to you, porcupine head?
Oh, I'm sorry.
That stupid clock doesn't matter, okay? She did it, and she should die for it! Die! Die!
Oh my god.
Harumph, harumph, harumph. Harumph, harumph, harumph.
Harumph.
What? Let's not get ahead of ourselves. This is a court of law, and the witness will calm her tits.
Oh my.
You've calmed too much. You've gone British.
Silly me. did I lose it? I guess I did. Look at my tits.
Gary.
Miss May, let me ask. Tell me, how did you know the weapon was a clock? Oh dear. Okay. Does the defense have any opinion on this behavior?
Oh shit, this is it.
Yes, Your Honor. Allow me to explain how I see the truth of the matter. Miss April May, you knew the weapon was a clock because...
You had heard of it. She didn't kill.
But if she knew Mr. White...
She could have, I suppose.
She probably heard about the weapon because Mr. White was keeping track of the daughter. You had heard about it, and then we give her the phone tap device. Maybe? The wiretap. Because when would she have held it? We have no evidence that she ever held it.
No, we don't.
We have some evidence that she had heard about it.
We know she's not the murderer from the Columbo section.
Right.
Alright, so she heard about it.
She heard about it, yeah. The witness had never held the clock in her hand. However, she had heard that it was a clock.
She heard?
That is correct, Your Honor. There is no other way she could have known the finger was a clock. And I can show you the proof.
Oh, well, I guess shit just got real. Okay, let's see it then. Show me the evidence proving the witness had heard the murder weapon was a clock.
Here it is. Then we show the wiretap.
Yeah, because she heard the phone conversation. That's brilliant, Jack. Brilliant.
I'm Kenny Powers. Mr. Evans, Mr. Packard, have you seen Catch Me If You Can? Also, you were right, Rich. You can't fucking escape Star Wars today. My mom bought me an R2-D2 trash can. I thought I was on hallucinogens.
I have seen Catch Me If You Can.
It's a fine movie.
Yeah, it's a fine movie. Didn't blow my socks off, but...
No, it's a perfectly competent movie with Leo and Tom.
Yeah.
It's cute. You know what that movie is?
Spielberg, right?
It's a cute movie. Spielberg.
Yeah.
That's a movie that you catch it on cable and you put it on in the background. Everybody enjoys it. It's great. It's great. Okay, here we go. The wiretap.
Take that! Have a look at this.
I found this in Miss May's room, so it must be perfectly admissible evidence.
Mr. Wright, please explain to the court what it is.
Miss April May, you were tapping
the victim, Miss Mia Faye's phone, were you not?
Your Honor, this is irrelevant.
No, that Edgeworth. This is perfectly relevant. Your objection should be...
It might be overruled quickly.
How is this...
I'm not entirely sure that it is. Mr. Edgeworth, would you like to bring up the legality of him rifling through your witness's stuff? No? No? Huh. Okay. It troubles me that our witness was in possession of a wiretap.
It is outrageous. Does the defense truly claim that the witness was tapping her phone?
Absolutely.
Even if that was the case, which it is not, you still have to prove one thing. Did the victim ever say that the weapon was a clock on the phone?
Yes.
Can you prove that? I think not.
Oh yeah, I think I can. It's simple.
What?
Here's my proof. The proof that the victim said on the phone that the weapon is a clock.
Well, if we check here, it's a clock.
This made it look like the thinker.
Okay, great.
I told you the time.
Yeah. Boom.
Take that! I present the defendant's cell phone. Yes, we've seen that already. I have no idea what I'm talking about.
Listen once more to the conversation between the defendant and the victim. For me again, what's it this time? It's a doom. It's a clock. It's made to look like a statue. This was literally a minute and a half ago in their time.
That's how you knew the thinker was a clock. Am I wrong?
Your Honor, this is ridiculous.
Your Honor, look at the witness's face. Does she seem amused to you? The defense demands an answer. Witness, answer the question. Did you tap her phone? Miss May.
Shut up, all of you. What gives you the right to talk to me like that? You lawyer!
I would love for like a demon to spawn out from her, and this turns into like an action game right now. It lulls you into the defense attorney game.
It's no fair! Oh, you get ganging up on me like that! Oh, so I'm the bad girl? Is that it? Is that it?
That did it. The court's seen the real Miss April May now. Now to deal the final blow.
Why the wiretap? We think Mr. White did it, right? Is that what we're...
I mean, we know she did.
Why the wiretap?
Why the wiretap, yeah.
Why did you tap her phone? Answer the question!
Do I have to? In this murder trial? Is tippity tapping or irrelevant?
She's saying exactly what Edgeworth wants her to say. Miss May, you were tapping the victim's phone.
I hardly call that irrelevant.
While the court does not condone the defense's tone of voice, he has a point. Well, Miss May, do you have an explanation for the court? Can you prove you had nothing to do with this murder, even though you tapped her phone?
I'd like to see her pull that off.
Mr. Lawyer, I saw that evil, evil grin. You were probably thinking, I'd like to see her pull that off, weren't you?
She's good.
Well, look at my tits. And of course, I can and will.
You can't be serious. No way.
Way, I say, way. Oh, and I assure you I'm serious, Miss Lawyer.
Wrong.
Okay, so the killing happened around 9 at night? Why, that's just when I was getting room service from that sweet bellboy.
Room service?
Iced coffee, I believe it was. Iced coffee, you know, like normal coffee, but cold.
We know what iced coffee is.
If you don't drink it quick, the ice melts, and then you have just regular cold coffee.
Nope.
What?
What does bitch saying?
Well, we'll find out.
No, I'm being Phoenix here.
Oh, okay. So,
what does bitch saying?
I think I'm making this up. I asked the bellboy.
Ergo, the witness was not on the scene at the time of the murder.
But we never said she was at the scene.
No.
Right. We never said she was at the fucking scene.
So, where does that leave us?
It's my great displeasure to inform you that the witness appears to have been tapping the victim's telephone. However, that is a separate crime with no bearing on the current case whatsoever. Her testimony stands, She saw the defendant, Miss Mayfay, commit murder.
No, they're going to just let her walk away? There's no way I can win this unless I tie Miss May to the murder somehow.
She mentioned the bellboy.
Mm-hmm.
We get the bellboy to testify about her connection to Mr. White.
Okay.
Well. Yes. Call the bellboy.
That sounds good.
As a witness. Boom. The defense would like to call the hotel bellboy as a witness. There's something suspicious here, and I'm going to get to the bottom of it.
I think you sunk it quite low enough already.
I object to calling the bellboy. It's an offensive term. They prefer bellhops. Bellhops come in many different ages.
Also,
not just boys.
Also,
some are
bell person.
Bell person. Some are women.
Sexist. Yeah, yeah.
There are gender neutral bell people.
Yeah.
Why? What's your reason?
Because I hold that the wiretapping had nothing to do with the killing.
How likely is that?
First of all,
this is some highly suspicious behavior.
You're just grasping at straws here. The key witness happens to be just coincidentally is wiretapping the victim's phone. Let's just put this crazy. Come on.
Let's put this crazy talk right away.
However, if you agree to a one condition, I'll consent to calling this witness.
Well, how about we fucking talk to the judge first?
How about we just call the witness?
Condition?
Yes, if Miss April's May's alibi is not called into question after you examine the bellboy.
After I examine the bellboy?
Yeah, her alibi is not called into question after you examine the bellboy.
And then you will recognize that Miss April May was not the killer, thus she is innocent.
Yeah, but
we don't think
she's the killer anyway. Oh, this must be like the same dialogue you could use for either branch.
Maybe.
Is the thing. Because
yeah.
We could have accused her of being the killer.
Okay.
So.
Thereby, you must also accept the verdict of guilty for Miss Mayfay. That is my condition.
What?
Judge, do you have anything to say about this bizarre stipulations he's putting on me calling a witness?
Because it's totally the judge's call whether or not the witness is called. And so the judge can be like,
dude, Phoenix, you don't have to take that deal.
We'll just call the witness.
We'll just call the witness. That's totally cool. Otherwise, man.
I mean, obviously, it's a video game. It's video game logic,
yeah.
But.
Yeah.
Give up. I guess I'll just give up. Bink. No, okay. Obviously, we'll accept the condition. Obviously.
Understood. I accept your condition.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really weird. I would have just let you call him up. You did not need to do that.
Oh, it's too late now.
Also, you just verbally accepted his condition. You have literally no reason to follow through with that condition. It's not like a binding contract or anything. You're just two dudes talking. Just gonna put that out there, Phoenix. My man.
Fool. You're a fool. You fell right into my trap.
Uh-oh. Wait. Very well. The court calls the hotel bellboy. To the stand. Oh, yeah. Hotel bellboy. Hotel bellboy.
I believe we're ready for the witness to testify. He certainly does look like a bellboy. A bellhop. He looks like a bellhop.
Yes, sir. I received your summons in the middle.
He still got the tray in his hand.
Of course he does.
Of course he does. That's
because
great.
What if the governor won't wait a spot or two?
What would I do?
The unit. I'm happy to be of service.
Oh, that tea set looks rather heavy. So without further ado, the witness may begin his testimony.
Very good, sir.
Okay, the testimony.
I am the head bellboy. Bellop, sorry, sir. at the fine Gatewater Hotel, in business for 4 generations. I believe I received a call after 8 o'clock in the evening from our guest, Miss May. She asked for an iced coffee to be brought to her at 9 o'clock on the dot, sir. I brought it to her at precisely the requested time, of course. And I delivered the iced coffee to our guest, Miss May herself. What do we do when we're full? Just trying to get the voice back. It goes in and out, especially when you're reading text like this.
I see. The defense may begin. It's cross-examination.
Right. I'm ready. This is it. If I can't prove Miss May was involved with the murder now, Maya will be finished.
So what? We just need to pay attention to what we get, how we get to the message left by Mr. White, mm-hmm. Right?
All right. I am the head bellboy at the fine Gatewater Hotel, in business for 4 generations.
Like, we can't.
Well, they say it's never bad to press, so we'll press.
What exactly is it you do at the hotel? Well, everything required to me, sir. I check in guests, I check out guests, I clean rooms, I make beds, I even deliver room service, sir. I checked Miss May in personally. Are you always so prim?
Mr. Wright, you will refrain from asking frivolous questions.
I received a call after 8 o'clock in the evening from our guest, Miss May.
Hold it.
Are you sure it was Miss May on the phone? Absolutely, sir. Ha! How can you be so certain? I checked Miss May in personally, sir. Not only...
Losing the accent a little bit.
It's fine.
Okay.
Not only did I see... What do we do when we fall? Not only did I see her in a stunning radiance, but I also heard a voice. And then I saw them. And I... The point being, I remember her quite well, sir.
Well then.
She asked me for an iced coffee to be brought at 9 o'clock on the dot, sir.
Hold it!
9 o'clock on the dot, you see? Yes, I confirmed that detail several times. She was watching a program on the telly and wished to drink after she finished, sir. 9 o'clock, the time of the murder. I brought it to her at precisely the requested time.
So if 9 o'clock was the time of the murder and she was getting her iced coffee,
yeah. How was she looking out the window?
Right,
so we'll press him on that. Precisely 9 o'clock then. Precisely. Exactly, and most definitely, sir. 9 o'clock p.m. How can you be so sure? Miss May was quite insistent that it be brought there. Oh, bellboy, T.E., I'd like an iced coffee at exactly 9 o'clock.
It's usually specific.
Something like that, sir. Therefore, I knocked on her door at the crack of 9. Oidy go, whitey go, folly roger, mooka dookie. Why would she be so particular about the time? And I delivered the iced coffee to our guest, Miss May herself. So wait, should I present evidence now?
Well, of what?
Died from a blow. The autopsy report does not say 9 o'clock. Of the autopsy, you know, but the autopsy does not say 9 o'clock.
Just press. We'll wait.
Well, we already pressed about this.
Hold it!
You are sure it was Miss April herself? Absolutely, sir. Have you seen her knock us?
J-
Just putting that out there. Yes, sir. As in, so very, absolutely, sir. It's an endearing mannerism of mine. How come you're so very certain? Well, when I brought the room service, sir, the guest, sir, she favored me with an embracer, sir. Embracer? Is that French for embrace? Is French for kiss, sir. Oh, he must be a Frenchman. But not a French kiss, sir. More a peck on the cheek. Why would she have done that? I believe perhaps she was momentarily swayed by my prim demeanor, sir. It was a moment I shall never, ever forget, sir. Sounds pretty fishy to me. I think our Miss May was up to something and wanted the bellboy to remember her. It's no good. There's nothing there. Is that it?
Oh, tisk tisk. Finally, you understand. This bellboy has absolutely no reason to lie. Now, if you have any decency, you will end this rather tedious cross-examination here.
It was a bit tedious. The witness may leave the stand.
Can't let this happen, can I?
Protest?
Yeah.
I have to.
Wait! Please wait! Yes, does the defense have something to add?
One last question. Let me ask one last question!
Objection!
Oh, shit.
Your Honor, I must object. This charade of justice has just gone on long enough. I mean, wow.
Now, Mr. Edgeworth! All right, Mr. Wright, I'll give you one more question. That is all.
Okay, this is really it now. This is my last chance. What?
Them with the check-in. Can we go back in his testimony?
No.
He said them.
Did he?
When she checked in. Ask about the check-in.
Yeah, but he said them. I think he was referring to her.
Kids game. They're not going that far.
Ask about check-in. Okay. Tell me about check-in. Tell me about when you checked in, Miss May. Oh, all right. Very well, sir. My first thought was that she was a beautiful, beautiful person. She's just my type of girl, so it was a disappointment, really.
I mean, rich ends, everyone.
Ladies and gentlemen. Famous attorney, Rich Evans.
I see. Who? Excuse me, what exactly was a disappointment? Oh, well, I am not without charm, sir. But even I'd have a little chance with a lover there. What did he say? What did you
say? I appreciate that, Phoenix, right? But you could just go right into the...
Oi, rather... Bellboy, tell us the truth now! Did Miss May check in with another person?
I object. That was, objectionable?
What? Yeah. You're not even trying anymore. I want to put this on the court record. Stenographer, are you typing this down? He is not trying anymore. Just putting that out. Come on. Objection overruled. The witness will answer the question.
Yes, I see. Why did you not mention this in your testimony? Well, sir, you didn't ask. Nice try. That's the sort of thing you're normally supposed to mention. Oh, yes. Oh, quite, sir. Why do we fault? Do we fault? It was the good barrister there, Mr. Edgeworth.
Dun dun dun!
He asked me not to mention it if I wasn't specifically asked, sir.
Oof!
Oh,
oaf.
Oh, sorry.
you fool!
I've done it. I've won. Miss April May checked into a twin room with a man! Correct? Yes, sir. Then, when you brought them room service, you didn't see that man in the room. Oh, that's right, sir. Your Honor, we have just learned of another person involved who may have been the murderer. In light of this new fact, I hold that it's impossible to judge the defendant. Wouldn't you agree, Mr. Edgeworth?
Yeah, and who, Mr. Wright? Who is this other person?
Simple. It was...
the man with Miss May.
Duh. The man who checked in with Miss May.
Oof.
Your Honor. As has been previously revealed, Miss April May was tapping the victim's phone. Can we not forget that? Because that is really linked to this case. Yet, Miss May herself has an alibi at the time of the murder. However, that does not clear the man that was with her. The bellboy saw no one else in the room at the time of the murder!
Oh, my, what a convenient little setup, but it's too late.
Too late? I suppose you'd like it if it was too late, wouldn't you?
Kind of. That'd be very convenient for me right now, as a matter of fact. Oh, boy. Oh, gee.
After all, it was you who hid the presence of the other man from this court.
Oof. Yeah, upstart. Amateur. These accusations, well, they are ludicrous.
Enough. The court acknowledges the defense's argument. I expect the prosecution and defense to look into this matter fully. Am I understood?
Yes. Yes, Your Honor.
That is all today for the trial of Maya Fey. That was a nice rhyme. Look at me. I'm a hip-hop star. Court is adjourned.
This is a delightful game.
This is a delightful game, I agree. Oi. Oh, hold on, we need to get through this.
Mr. I got the wrong.
Saving game! Oh, fuck. Fuck Rich Evans.
Yeah. So is this a one long case, or does this game have several different murders?
Well, so far this is the second case.
That was like a tutorial earlier.
Oh, sure. I wonder.
So is this whole game this one case?
I can't imagine so. No one knows. Multiple cases.
Okay.
I mean, we are obviously taking way too long with this because we're fucking around a lot.
And every case is multiple days then. That's nice.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah. First case has 5 cases.
You mean chapters?
Cases. Is it? First has 5 cases? First game has 5 cases.
Oh, never mind.
Great. Cool. All right. Well, let's call that a night.
Yeah, I think we're done. what do we got here?
Twitcher. Twitcher. There's the Twitcher. Good old Twitcher.
Beermeister 2089.
Tiberius Kirk.
One small ball.
Confusion grows 0.
Grand Moff Kali, 19 months in a row.
Yes, Ikatarzo, 15 months in a row.
Xenotrope, 22 fucking months in a row.
You monster. 14 months in a row.
Lurdiak!
Tour guide Nixon!
Riot crew! 23 fucking months in a row.
Ultimazer!
I'm not gonna stop you. I'm not gonna stop you. And dead neutral! It's the big 2-0! 20 fucking months in a row!
Tim Salmons!
Cameron Mitchell's ghost!
Bill LaHecka, 23 fucking months in a row!
Toasty Bullets!
Valastyrus. Valastrius. Valastrius.
Boojabit!
Dr. Soyanez! 13 months in a row!
Haps 78.
Norweeman.
VG 64.
This time it's
Lupus. You're madman. You're madman. Anonymous says, Jack, I thought you were going to talk about Civil War.
Lupus.
We'll talk about Civil War next time. I don't have especially strong thoughts about the movie. All said and done.
And I haven't seen the half in the bag yet, and so I'm sure you would just be repeating a lot of shit.
We'll talk about it next stream.
Give us some more time for people to watch it. I thought it was
pretty
good.
Well, I mean, I just...
No, it's too late tonight.
It's midnight.
I thought it was pretty good. But, you know, it was all right.
What was your opinion? All right or good or great or...
It was good.
It was good?
It was just good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little, maybe like a hair below that. But it was good.
It was good.
It was good.
It was good. I thought the story was maybe a little recycled from Winter Soldier. And,
I almost wish they kept it smaller.
That was the thing.
The actual big fight at the airport was just gratuitous. It was like, here's the set piece, here's the circus.
Every single fight scene, except for the final one, was gratuitous.
Stick to the interesting character stuff.
You know? Right. The fights were fun. They were really fun to watch, but they just didn't mean anything. Anyway, yeah, but obviously.
Yep.
Yeah. It was good. Where were we? Lupus.
Purple Space Bazooka! 16 months in a row!
Spike! 1, 3, 8, 2, 19 months in a row.
Harry Fed! 16 months in a row.
Zara Fimi.
And Tom! Oh my god, I fucked it up.
Wow.
Fucked it up already. First letter.
Wow.
First syllable. The first letter, I fucked it up. And Tom Tardy! Thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it.
It's true. We really do